Hi everyone, welcome, good evening. Please check whether I'm audible and visible, guys. Welcome, welcome, good evening. गुड इवनिंग गुड इवनिंग. क्या ऑडियो वीडियो क्लियर है? बताइए प्लीज, रिप्लाई विद यस और नो. गुड इवनिंग. सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड गाइस. सो वी आर डूइंग अ टॉपिक दैट इज प्रेपोजिशन एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू द टॉपिक. हरी अप, जॉइन इन द क्लास. शुड वी स्टार्ट नाउ? Okay, so guys, we were doing some preposition and the topic is preposition. We will continue with this topic, preposition of place and preposition of moment. So if something is placed in something, like there is a box and you put something inside it, you can say in the box. Agar koi cheez kisi cheez ke andar hai, like in this box, you can see there is a ball. Okay, so we will say there is a ball in the box. And if something is on it, you will say on the box. If something is under it, you will say, if something is like this in this position, you will say under the box. Agar koi cheez bagal mein hai, you will say next to it. Agar koi cheez do cheezon ke beech mein hai, between is used for two things, and among for more than two things. If there are lots of boxes and one ball, we will say there is one ball among these boxes. And there are two boxes and one ball, we will say between the boxes. Okay? And something is in front of it, it means samne. Behind matlab piche. Above means there is a height and there is a gap between the box and the ball, there is a gap, then we will say above. If something is under it but having some gap, we will say below it, below the box. If it is somewhat touching, thoda bahut touch mein hai, then it is under. Okay, near matlab pass mein. Near the box means pass mein, close to the box. Away from the box means far away, far from, dur hona kisi cheez se. Okay, now we talk about the movement, prepositions of movement. You can say if something is coming down from the stairs, you will say down the stairs. Agar koi cheez niche ki taraf aa rahi hai, you will say down the stairs. Okay, agar koi cheez niche ki taraf aa rahi hai, you will say down the stairs. Okay, great. So here, if something is going upward, then we will say up the stairs. Then we will say up the stairs. Okay. If something is going out, we will say out of the box. If something is coming in, we will say into, because it suggests us motion. If something is in motion, यानी कि कोई चीज गति में है और वो किसी चीज के अंदर जा रही है, we will say into. Into the box, because the ball is doing motion here. If something is in motion and going inside something, then we will say into the box. Koi cheez bahar ja rahi hai, then out of the box. Upar ja rahi hai, to up the stairs. Niche aa rahi hai, to down the stairs. Got it? Sujata, please control. This is not the right time to ask this question. Okay, I'll reply when the right time will come. Now you need to focus on this slide and you need to clear these concept. After or at the end of the class, we will discuss all these things. Okay, सो वंस अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू रिपीट इट, अगर कोई चीज सीढ़ियों से नीचे आ रही है यू विल से डाउन द स्टेयर्स, इफ समथिंग इज गोइंग अपवर्ड अप द स्टेयर्स यू विल से अप द स्टेयर्स, अगर कोई चीज मोशन करके बाहर आ रही है इफ इट इज कमिंग आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स वी विल से आउट ऑफ, इफ समथिंग इज गोइंग इन मोशन इन साइड समथिंग यू विल से इन टू. फॉर एग्जाम्पल ही, जस्ट अ सेकेंड, ही केम इन ऑब्लिक इन टू द बॉक्स. व्हाट शुड बी द राइट आंसर? सॉरी, इन टू द रूम. He came in oblique into the room. What should be the right answer? So here you are to just check whether the verb given is of motion verb or not. If it is of motion verb, then we will write into. Okay? He came into the box. He came into the room. Sorry. He came into the room. He came into the room. So here we can see this verb denotes us the motion. If it is denoting us the motion, if it is denoting us the motion, we will write into in that case. We will write into in that case. Okay? Got it? Great job. So he is dash the room in or into. What should be the right answer? In this case number one, the answer is into. What is the reason behind it? What is the reason behind it? Because it is denoting us the motion. And he is dash the room. Here we cannot see any kind of motion. So we will write in. He is in the room. Got it? Any doubt over here? Good. Any doubt over here? Okay. Because we are writing in here because there is no motion. We are not denoting any kind of motion. In means under. And into means motion. So in this case, motion is given. Okay, that's the reason. Now we will learn some more concept based on it. In this case, you learn out of and into. The ball is going inward the box, so that's why we are writing into. Okay, and if something is going towards the box, what is the meaning of towards? Towards means ki taraf. It is not necessary that thing will go to the or that thing will reach to the destination, but it means वो चीज़ उसकी तरफ जा रही है. It is going in the direction of something, then you will write toward. Okay? For an example, I am saying, मान लेते हैं कि किसी लड़के का नाम है दीपक. And Deepak is a boy who is only 2 years old, and his parents are very upset because he came out of the house and he wandered here and there. वो कहीं चला जाता है. Their parents were really very upset and they were searching for his son Deepak. Where is Deepak? So they were running in the street and asking that whether you have son, my child who is 2 years old and he just came out of the house. Do you know him or have you seen that kind of person who is only 2 years old? Okay. So then nobody replied, but the one person said that he was going towards the station. Towards the station. So guys, there are two type of preposition. One is to and second is towards. टू एंड टुवर्ड्स. दीपक वॉज गोइंग. हेयर यू हैव टू फिल द ब्लैंक. द स्टेशन. मैंने दीपक को स्टेशन की तरफ जाते हुए देखा. देन यू विल राइट व्हाट? यू विल राइट टुवर्ड्स. व्हाई? बिकॉज यू आर नॉट श्योर दैट ही वॉज गोइंग टू द स्टेशन बिकॉज ही इज अ किड. एंड कैन यू से दैट ही इज गोइंग टू द स्टेशन? नो. यू जस्ट सी दैट दैट बॉय, दैट लिटिल बॉय, दैट पर्सन हुज नेम इज दीपक, यू विल से दैट ही वॉज गोइंग टुवर्ड्स द रेलवे स्टेशन बिकॉज you just seen that he was going towards in that direction. If you are just mentioning that he, that that person was going in the direction of something, then you will say towards. So Deepak was going towards the station. Okay, towards the station. If I say Deepak is going to station, so it means I am definitely, I am sure that the person is going to the station. वो station पे ही जा रहा है. If you are sure that he is going to there, he is going there, then you can write to. Otherwise, you will write towards. Okay. That person said he saw the baby going dash school. Here are two options, to and towards. What should be the right answer here? To or towards? That person said he saw the baby going to or towards the school. So here the right answer is towards. Towards would be the better answer. If you are saying that the baby is going to school, और वो भी बच्चे को, baby मतलब तो छोटा बच्चा हो गया ना, तो towards would be a better answer over here. Okay, two can be written, but two would not be preferable answer in this case because a baby cannot go to school. छोटा बच्चा school नहीं जाएगा, तो इसलिए हम क्या कहेंगे? Towards the school बोलेंगे. ठीक है, अकेला नहीं जाएगा. और यहाँ पर भी कह रहा है the man said, we can take an idea from here. The man, the person said, उस व्यक्ति ने कहा कि उसने उधर जाते हुए देखा, है ना? That is the difference. Okay, अब मैं बोलूँ he is going to school, then it is okay. वह school जा रहा है, then it is okay. Because nobody is mentioning here. यहाँ पर कोई कह नहीं रहा है, आपने सीधा ही बोल दिया कि वो जा रहा है school. He is, here the person is mentioned. Somebody else is telling that the person, that the baby is going towards school. That is the difference. Okay? The basic difference between to and towards means, the basic difference between to and towards means in the direction of something. In the direction of something. In the direction of something. किसी चीज की direction में. Okay? Got it? And to means to the destination. What do you mean by destination? Means the place where you are going. Specific destination. You are damn sure that the person is going to that place. Okay? If someone else is telling, the chances of towards will be there in the options. Okay? I think you got it. So let's move to the next question. Away means dur jana. Pass means pass kar jana. Like a car passed you. It means a car aapke pass se nikal gayi. Got it? Okay. So I'm just going to give you an exercise also, but after it, okay? Now we will learn what is the basic difference between on to and upon. Okay? There is a table and there is a book on this table, we will say the book is on the table. The book is on the table. And there is another case where we saw a cat who is jumping from the floor to the table, or that cat jumped here. Okay, then we will say the cat jumped and set dash, or you can say just a second. The table. Then what should be the right answer? On or onto? Then what should be the right answer in this case? So here the answer will be onto. Can you tell me the reason? Because the book is already on the table. There is no motion. If these all means upar or par, but this is for used for the rest. If something is at rest, this is used when something is in motion, and this is used when something is in continuous motion. Okay. Once again, I am telling, on means something is at rest, onto means something in motion, and upon means continuous motion. On means continuous motion. Okay. Welcome, welcome. Getting it? Please try to understand. Do not do extra comments and try to focus on the class and pay full attention to the class so that you can get out of you can get maximum out of it. So here it is given that something is at rest. If something is at rest, we will write on there. If something is in motion, we will write on to. We will write on to. Okay. If something is in continuous motion, we will write upon. I am going to explain the upon also. But now you need to understand on once again. If something is at rest, we will say the book is on the table. Okay, I will give the example of upon also. But try to understand and be patient. Okay. Okay. So now I am also going to explain that if the book is at rest, like you saw that there is a table and the book is already on the table, it means we will say the book is on the table. Okay. Then what we did, we threw the book, or we put the book on the table. Like I am writing, he put the book on or onto. You all guys know that whenever you put something, it becomes motion. So what should be the right answer here? He put the book on or onto. He put the book onto the table. In this case, we have written onto. What is the reason? Because we are writing put here, and put is a motion. Put denotes motion. If something denoting motion is written, then we will write onto. That's why I have mentioned here, if something is in motion, and आप कहना चाहते हो कि कोई चीज किसी चीज के ऊपर रखी गई है और वो गति की अवस्था में है, मोशन में है, then we will say on to. If something is at rest, then we will say on. Okay. So that's why the answer is on to. Now I'm writing another example. Just a second. I'm going to write here. Just a second. I'm writing another example, and then I will give you the example of upon also. Okay. I'm writing example. The cat is sitting dash the table. Can you tell me the answer? What should we write, on or onto? What should we write? The cat is sitting dash the table. We will say the cat is sitting on the table, because here cat is not doing any kind of motion. Here cat is not doing any kind of motion. That cat is just in the position of sitting. That cat is just seated over here. Okay. So that's why we are writing on. But if you remember, in the last case, here the cat jumped onto the table, because here the motion verb was given. Here we saw a verb which was denoting motion to us. If something is denoting motion, then we will write onto. Is it clear now? Is it on and onto clear to you? Now we are going to discuss about upon. Okay, now we are going to discuss about upon, how to use upon. Okay, so you can take an example. If there is a cat or any baby who is continuously jumping upon something, like a cat is there on the table and that cat is continuously jumping on that table, so what we will say? The cat is jumping. If the cat is jumping, it cannot happen that the cat is jumping continuously here and here, again and again. In that case, what should we write? On, onto, or upon? Here it denotes continuous motion. The cat is jumping on, onto, upon the table. What should be the right answer over here? Very good. The cat is jumping upon the table. The cat is jumping upon the table. Got it? Yes, yes. If there is ing, yes, you are right. If there is ing structure, this denotes a continuous action. That continuous action is being done. It means we are going to write upon there. Okay. There are some words. Act upon. Act will take upon with it. If you see the word act, we will write upon. Once, we can write upon. Once upon a time. Okay. He acted upon. Okay, you can write, if you see once, then you can write upon, act upon. So this is the basic difference between on, onto, and upon. I think now is it clear? Are on, onto, and upon, all these are clear to you? Okay, so now I'm going to give you very important thing now. So do you have our English book? If you have our English book in the study kit, there is a list of important preposition, guys. The prepositions which are continuously being asked in the competitive and the school entrance exam, different kind of school entrance exam. Okay. If you do not have this study kit, you can order. The number is given below. Okay. You can do WhatsApp and you can order this study kit. This list is really very, very important, guys. This list is really very, very important. So here, what we are to do is, here some words are given, and with those words specific preposition will come. There is no rule and regulation for all these. We are to just learn these preposition. okay, we are to make the habit to by using, like if you speak English, you do use this type of phrase, according to me, according to my father, according to him. So according will take to. If you see the word according, we will write to there. Okay, please speak after me, according to. Ek bar mere saath bolenge sabhi bacche, according to, according to. So according word is seen, then we will write to with it. Now the very important question, that is really very very important, that is afraid. So now you people will speak with me, afraid of, afraid of. So afraid will take of with it. Afraid means dar, fear of something. Afraid of means fear of something. I am not afraid of ghost, mujhe bhooton se dar nahi lagta. Afraid will take preposition of with it. And 2 to 3 times this concept has been asked in your exams. Okay, this is really very very important. Agree will take with. Agree with, take with. If you are writing a person, then you can say agree with the person. Agree with the person. I agree with you. Main tumse sehmat hu. I agree with you. I agree to a proposal. Main tumhare proposal se sehmat hu. If something is written, then we will write to. If person is written, then we will write with. It means if you are talking about any person, you will write there with. Like I agree with you. I agree with Deepak. I agree with Mahesh. I agree with Sorya. I agree with Anand. I agree with Kritika. I agree with Borang. I agree with Anand. Okay. I agree with Saraswati. I agree with Aditya. Any name can you can write. That should be a name of any person. If you are writing with, you can put the name of any person. Because with will be written when you are writing the name of any person or any pronoun, if any person is mentioned. Okay, then agree, there is given agree to. If we are we are able to see, or we do not find any person, we find something different, like something is written, your proposal, your demand, your agreement, like this is written, then we will write agree to. Once again I am going to repeat it. According to, afraid of, agree with the person. If person is written, we will write with. And if except person, anything else is written, then we will write agree to. It means agree can take two different type of preposition. One is with, another is to. First is with, another is to. It means if person is written, we will write with there. And if something else except person is written, then we will write to there. Got it? Great job. So till now we have completed only 4. And now I am going to give some example which are asked in the previous year exams based on these concepts. Okay, these are really very very important concepts. So guys, can you tell me that what should be the answer for question number first? Hurry up, answer question number first. What should be the right answer? Manju is afraid dash maths. What should be the right answer for this? Very good, very good, very good. So the right answer is of, afraid of maths. Manju is afraid of maths. Manju ko kis se dar lagta hai? Maths se dar lagta hai. So of will be the right answer. You are really very, very great people. You are doing a great job. So if your answer is of, then it is correct. Now, there are around 55 words given. If you learn all the 55 words, you will be able to clear the preposition topic 100%, because the examiner asks mostly from these type of words where we use specific preposition. So that's why sometimes we call words
you can see the name of this also. List of important appropriate preposition. What is the meaning of appropriate here? It means these are fixed preposition which will be used. Okay, so now here given agree on, here given agree on. Here I have taught you that if person is written, then we will write agree with. If proposal, demand or anything else is given, then we will write agree to. If any point is given, then we will write on over there. We all agree on this point. For example, I am giving an example over here. Just a second. Let me just get the blank page. Here we go to blank page. So now I am giving you an example. I agree Can you try filling these blanks without any option? I can give you options also. Okay, let me just give you options. In the first blank, I'm giving you the options. You can choose out of the given options. No. Very good. So here four options are given. You are to select which option is the correct one for this. Very good. Try it. Very good. If your answer is option number C, then your answer is correct. Agree with someone, because someone is written, you is a person here. So we will write agree with. Demand or proposal, for demand or proposal or anything, I have told you, if something or anything is written, demand, proposal is written, we will write to over there. And if point is written, we will write on there. Got it? So now you have to learn this. I agree with you, but not to this demand or not to this proposal, but and not on this point also. Okay? You can see this example where that is written, this one. Agree with the person, agree to proposal, agree on some point. Got it? Agree on the point, agree to the proposal, and agree with the person. Is it okay now? So if point is written, we will write on. If proposal, demand, request is written, we will write to. If person is written, we will write with. Is it clear now? Very good. So now we are going to learn another word, that is angry at, and these are really very important because these are directly being asked in the exams. So you are to pay full attention. If you can purchase the study kit, then try to purchase this study kit also, because this would be really very, very beneficial for you guys, because there are lots of examples to practice in this book. Okay, we have two English books, and in that study kit you find English, Maths, Reasoning and all the books that you want to get, and there will be a second book for the practice of each subject. So now we are going to talk about angry at something. It means something is written, then we will write at, and if person is written, then we will write with. Okay, जैसे the teacher was angry with me, teacher मुझसे गुस्सा थे. The teacher was angry at my mistake. So here something is written, mistake is something, so we will write at, and here me is a person, so I'm writing with. Okay, got it? Great job. What should be the right answer? My father is angry dash my mistake. Angry at my mistake is the right answer. Angry at my mistake, because mistake is something. Mistake is not a person, okay? But brother is another person. So what should be the right answer in the second one? This is first and this is second. What should be the right answer in the second one? Good. My father is angry with my brother. Angry with my brother. Because here brother is a person. And if someone is angry with a person, then you will write with. And if we are talking about something, then you will write at. Okay. So like this, you are to learn this. Okay. Try to learn this complete. If you can learn this complete, that would be really very beneficial to you guys. Okay. There are approximately more than 1000 words which are followed by appropriate preposition, but you need to learn only 55, and in the exams out of these 55 questions will be asked. Okay, because these are really very common for the students who are in the schools. For the school students, this is important. Okay, so you are to try to complete this one. Okay, so there will be a test tomorrow. I am going to display this one. There will be a test on the same concept. Okay, there will be a test of these 55 words. You are to learn this. Okay, Samantha, ready? Please keep patience. I'm going to tell you that try to complete this, and there will be a test of it. Okay, you can complete it. It will take some time, but you can complete it. Can you complete 55, all the 55, or should I take half of it, of 25? How many should be involved in the test? 25 or all the 55? प्लीज कमेंट 55 और 25 मींस कितने टेस्ट के अंदर इन्वॉल्व करना चाहिए हमें. ओके सो आई एम गिविंग यू 25. ओके अप टू 25 आई एम गिविंग. अप टू हेयर यू आर टू कंप्लीट दिस. ओके अप टू हेयर. ओके आई एम गिविंग यू 25. वंस अगेन प्लीज लिसन, आई एम गिविंग यू 25. दीज 25 यू आर टू कंप्लीट. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कंप्लीट यू कैन सी द रिकॉर्डेड वीडियो एंड देन यू कैन टेक डाउन द नोट्स ऑल्सो. एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ऑर्डर द स्टडी किट, द नंबर इज गिवन बिलो. यू कैन ऑर्डर दिस इन द स्टडी किट ऑल्सो. द नंबर इज गिवन हेयर. ओके if you want to purchase a full study kit you can purchase the full study kit also, and if you want to purchase for English you can also purchase for the English. Got it? But there will be a test tomorrow. Okay, tomorrow is the test day. As you all know, tomorrow is Friday and Friday is a test day. So there will be a test of English on these 25. Got it? On these 25 you are to learn. How to remember these things? Try to recall again and again. Like speak like this. Agree with the person. Agree to proposal. Agree with the person. Agree to proposal. Agree on a point. Agree on a point. Like this if you will speak, you will become habitual. Like you are, like listen to me. Listen to me. You are habitual of this word. Listen to me. You always use to with it. It is automatically used by us. Why? Because we have become habitual by using again and again. According to me, you always use according to me. Why? Because we become habitual of using these words again and again. So now it's your homework is to complete 25. Okay? Thank you so much. See you in the next class. Bye-bye.